First at 5:30, the disaster in Haiti. It's the fourth day of desperation.
Aid has arrived on the island, but officials are still struggling to reach all of the earthquake survivors.
Governments and agencies across the globe have pledged about $400 million in aid.
The UN says up to 50% of the buildings in the capital and other hard-hit areas are damaged or destroyed.
Just moments ago, President Barack Obama announced that Haitians in the U.S. illegally will be granted temporary amnesty.
We have live in-depth coverage tonight. Eyewitness News reporter Danielle North spoke with a Providence firefighter who's helped the people of Haiti in the past.
But first, let's go to Catherine Sotnick, who is live inside the Rhode Island Red Cross headquarters in Providence.
Well, donations have been pouring in, but of course, much more help is needed. And we have the local branch of the Red Cross here in Providence, you can see, taking phone calls. They will be here till 8 o'clock tonight. They're taking questions. If you have any questions or donations at this point, you can see that number at the bottom of your screen. It's 831-7700. Again, they're taking questions and donations over the phone. Also, a big way of donating this year, rather, has been through text messaging. All you have to do is text Haiti to 90999. I have the phone backwards. Haiti to 90999. It will charge your phone a $10 donation, but we have it all broken down for you on our website as well, WPRI.com. It has, under the No More section, a complete list of the ways you can donate. The number here, if you didn't catch that, at the bottom of your screen. And there have been quite a lot of donations coming in. With me now, I have the CEO of Rhode Island Red Cross, Bruce Rutter. And I'm going to have you come over here. I'll meet you halfway. So how are things going so far for you?
Okay.
We've been pulling in many phone calls over the past
calls, walk-ins all day long, and the phones have been ringing off the hook. A lot of people are still asking, can they do food and clothing drives? And at this point, we don't need food and clothing. The very first Red Cross teams landed in Port-au-Prince this afternoon, along with two airplanes full of medical supplies and a mobile hospital. It's going to take days before they begin to set up shelters, and it'll be weeks before we need that kind of goods.
Absolutely. And another very interesting point, we have 31 trained Red Cross, Rhode Island Red Cross members on standby tonight. Explain, they're just waiting right now for the call.
They are chomping at the bit. These are people who've been deployed before. They were at 9/11, Hurricane Katrina. They were down for Ike and Gustav. Doctors, nurses, shelter managers, mental health professionals were just waiting for the call from the National Red Cross.
Okay, well, thank you so much, Bruce. And again, the phone bank will be here till 8 o'clock. If you want to make a donation, you can call this number or log on to our website. We'll be back live at 6. Reporting live with the Providence Mobile Newsroom, I'm Catherine Sotnick, Eyewitness News.